Session is for discussion on traditional music and how it has impacted Hindi film song. I think one of the things that we would all agree upon is that the Hindi film song as a genre is very hybrid. It brings together many, many influences, and in this session we have three very eminent panelists who will tell us what they think is the impact of many, many forms of traditional music in India, how that has impacted Hindi film song. So I'd like to welcome Tushar Bhatia ji. So Tushar ji is a very eminent composer, has studied Hindustani classical music at depth, and of course is a very accomplished sitar player himself. But he also has a formidable study of many, many other forms of music, including Western classical music. He has provided the music for several films, for many projects, and has also created education modules for music education purposes. I'd now like to call Mr. Kaushal Inamdar, another very well-known composer. Kaushal ji is an author, a poet, and a composer. His work in composing for films has been greatly acclaimed, and in fact there's a huge list of awards that he has received, and many more I'm sure that will come. But one of the most, the one that caught my eye was for his work, the music that he composed for the film Bal Gandharv, for which he received the Dada Saheb Phalke Memorial Award. I'd also like to invite Mrudula Dadhe Joshi. She is an assistant professor in the music department in the University of Bombay. But her work, her research work, has been focused on Hindi film music, and she has been awarded a PhD thesis on her work in studying composers for Hindi films who have had an experimental streak. She's also written many, many papers, academic papers, on the work of several composers. So basically all three of these eminent panelists share one thing in common: a deep and abiding interest in studying not just music, but film music in particular. The first question that I would like to put to all of you, and maybe Tushar ji, you can start, is to briefly tell us that in this very hybrid world of the Hindi film song, do you think, is there a DNA, is there a gene of traditional music that can be traced in the evolution of the Hindi film song genre? And if so, please tell us what you think, briefly, because we have much to discuss. So what is the impact of traditional music, and where do you find that?
As it goes, film music, everything goes. We are allowed to do everything. I'll go back to 1931 when talkie cinema started. Anil Bishwas ji, the great composer, who came in immediately, almost immediately after R.C. Boral ji and Pankaj Malik cast their spell in new theatres in the early 30s. And he says, I came away to Bombay because nobody was looking at me in Calcutta. He says, first I came, and then S.D. Parman Sahab also came. And he says, when I came, which means around 35, 36, Dharam Ki Devi was his first film. He says, I had a blank canvas. I could paint whatever I wanted. And he says, I also worked with non-singers who were stars, and it was being lapped up. Now, earlier, in the 30s, 40s, since there was no tradition of film music, since it was a blank canvas, there was theatre music, there was classical music, thumris, ghazals, folk music, many forms. All forms of folk music, of course, existed for thousands of years. My hand is... So, I think in the beginning, it was highly influenced by theatre music, when singers sang loudly and there was just minimum instruments
as in tabla. And harmonium also, which was actually not an Indian instrument, has become so Indian now that people forget that it's not even an Indian instrument. And it's considered as the very, very basic form of harmonium. So all the genres, which was including ghazals, were used very heavily. The main language was Urdu in talkie cinema. And folk forms, we find them in the 30s, eventually with playback coming in and technology increasing, you had a tapestry of musicians which was called the orchestra. That itself was an innovation. And if I'm not mistaken, that was done by Pankaj Malik Sahab and R.C. Boral Sahab in New Theatres. They put in about 13, 14 to 20 musicians together. And obviously, when the musicians were playing together, they were not playing only one thing. They were playing several parts. Now, this was a big breakaway from traditional music, as we know folk music and classical music to be, because we have a single form of music, a single line of music, monophonic form. So, even if the traditional forms like Dhire Baho Nadia, Dhire Dhire Baho Utar Nahi Paaye, Achyut Kanya Ka Gaana, or Chudi Lelo Main Laya Anmol Re, they were still in a very different genre that was being created by the masters. A new grammar was being written for the films in the 30s. Eventually, in 40s, 50s, 60s, and till now, there has been actually a tradition of film songs. No, traditional music jo bolte hai na, wo film song hi apna aap mein ek tradition ban gaya. Ghoda Gaadi ka gaana Pankaj Malik sahab ne invent kiya 1941 mein, Doctor film mein. Aur Naushad sahab ne bahut gaane banaye, phir O.P. Nair sahab ne banaye. To us pe ek chhaap lagi ke Ghoda Gaadi ka gaana invented by Pankaj Malik, that jhumpak jhumpak rhythm. To wo tradition ban gaya. To jab maine gaana banaya andaaz apna apna mein, to bole are O.P. Nair ki copy ki hai. Nair sahab ne wo gaana suna tha, bole bahut hi kamal ka hai, whatever it was, but wo ek tradition tha. Same cabaret gaane jo
if I might interrupt, so sure. I understand that you said that some of the forms of traditional music that found traces in what emerged as the Hindi film song were music from theater.
Yes.
So would you say music from folk theater like Nautanki?
Yes, yes, okay. Very much.
Okay, then you said ghazal,
yes,
as well as any other forms, because what we are...
Khayal.
Khayal, okay.
Khayal was very much there. Bandish Ko Thumri was there.
Okay.
Very much. I would say lohris were there.
Yes.
Soja Rajkumari is a lohri.
Okay, so but there are not, all these forms of traditional music.
Absolutely.
Kaushalji, would you like to add to that?
But Shubhaji, sorry, I'm interrupting. The forms were there, but the compositions were fresh.
Yes, I
that's what I'm trying.
This is just
Namaskar. Just to introduce, it's not a coincidence that the highest philosophical treatise of this land is called Bhagavad Gita. We do everything in a song. People say that India is a land of mountains and rivers, of elephants and tigers. But you will definitely agree, I think it's a land of stories and songs. To tell a story in a song is, in a way, our dharma. We tell stories in a song and our songs depict stories, whatever. So, there is no moving away from tradition, even if we want to. I don't think there is such a gravitational pull. So unless the ozone layer is not really destroyed, that gravitational pull towards the ozone layer of traditional music as it exists outside of films, until that exists, I don't think that gravitational pull of tradition will ever go away from Hindi film. Now, a short experience. Tusharji said that in 1931-32, talkies started. Alamara and, pardon me, I'll just make a disclaimer that although we are talking about Hindi film music, because I have worked in Marathi very often, I feel now that regional languages are becoming mainstream. So Hindi word to take it a little leniently, we can use examples of some Marathi songs. Especially Ayodhya Raja began the same year as the shooting started, in the same year as my grandfather played the violin in Ayodhya Raja, Shankar Rao Biniwale. Okay, so there were three musicians and the singer sang. Govind Rao Tembe was a musician and the actor and the singer, because the singers had two. Now, because Govind Rao Tembe also had a credit as the first music composer in a play, in Manappan, and in a film, in Ayodhya Raja. So, now most of the music that started at that time did come, as Tusharji said, from the theater. Now the music of the theater, which Anna Saheb Kirloskar started, it came from the Kirtan Parampara, it came from the Karnataka side. So there was no moving away. Now when I became a music composer in 98 and I had no formal training, in fact the first recording that I saw was Tusharji's. He might not remember.
I remember.
So when I came, analog recording was still going on and we were moving towards the digital age. So like Godo, we were only hearing that the digital age is going to come. The CD will come, everything will change, that his sound of the analog recording will go forever. Now everybody was excited, everybody was afraid also of what the change would be. And at that precise time, when we began our careers, the analog age was passing and the digital age was rumored to be coming, and we were standing on the seashore waiting for the tsunami of digital technology to consume us. When it finally came, musicians which could not, which were from the old school, couldn't really manage with the digital. They said that it's useless, and they started missing that hiss. But in this time, we saw an entire digital medium called the CD or the DVD just. So I have seen a technology born in front of my eyes and almost die, where the analog technology remained for a long time. Now this had a pronounced effect on how traditional music was treated. For example, Anish ji is here. Sound of the tabla changed after digital music came. The way Rahman started treating the sound of the tabla and even the bowls were totally different from how they were used by say S.D. Burman or Naushad ji. But they didn't stop using it.
So even now
they use it in a new way, and I don't think we will ever divorce traditional music in Indian films.
Mrudula ji, namaskar. For me, traditional music consists of many streams, like jaise classical hai, folk hai, ye sab traditions leke hi hum जो आज यहाँ पर पहुँचे हैं, जिस मकाम पर पहुँचे हैं. तो ट्रेडिशनल म्यूज़िक का इम्पैक्ट होना या किसी भी म्यूज़िक पर उसका कुछ असर होना बहुत ही नैसर्गिक, नेचुरल है. जैसा कि मैं मानती हूँ और हम सब मानते हैं रदर, कि फिल्म सॉन्ग इट्सेल्फ इज़ अ इंडिविजुअल जानर, मतलब एक्लेक्टिक हैं, काफ़ी सारे स्ट्रीम्स इसमें हैं, ट्रेडिशनल है, फोक है, लेकिन अपने आप में एक बहुत ही सशक्त विधा, अपने आप में एक इंडिविजुअल जॉनर के मायने में मैं रखती हूँ फिल्म सॉन्ग को, क्योंकि फिल्म सॉन्ग हैज़ टू बी लॉयल टू द स्क्रीन एंड द सिचुएशन. किसी भी विधा का उस पर असर होना डिपेंड करता है सिचुएशन पर. और जहाँ तक मैं मानती हूँ, ट्रेडिशनल म्यूज़िक में, एज फार एज क्लासिकल म्यूज़िक इज़ कंसर्न, आई कैन सी मेनी एलिमेंट्स फ्रॉम क्लासिकल म्यूज़िक रिफ्लेक्टिंग इन फिल्म सॉन्ग. एंड
my observation tells me ki it's not only limited to raga or raga application. It's very basic. Means agar classical ka use hum jise mante hain ki a particular raag par ek gana ho, lekin main manti hu ki elements ko, elements kya hai ki classical ka ek bahut hi important element hai improvisation. Hum use jante hain ki swatantrata ek abhivyakti ki swatantrata rehti hai lekin bandhan mein. You have to follow the rules of raag in classical. Phir bhi aap usse mante ho ki ye khud ka ek avishkar hona chahiye, pratibha honi chahiye, creativity honi chahiye. To improvisation agar hum ek element lete hain example ke taur par, to wo mujhe dikhai deta hai film song mein. Kafi sare composers hain jin mein Jaydev sahab ka main zikr karungi ki improvisation element unke gaane mein hai. Wo kaise aata hai ki ek line ko agar aap uski tarz badal ke do teen dafa ga rahe ho to aap mere khayal se honestly ek bol alap hi kar rahe ho. Hum bol alap kise kehte hain classical mein ki jo normal tune hai khayal ki ya bandish ki usko hum improvise karenge. To ek ye element hua classical ka, aur classical ka element Jaydev sahab jaise composer jo hain unke gaane mein dikhai deta hai kyunki wo unki maine aadat ya unka ek ट्रेंड देखा शैली में ऑब्जर्व किया कि एक लाइन को वो बहुत काफ़ी तरीके से घुमाते हैं. कैन आई डेमोन्स्ट्रेट बाई हमिंग बिकॉज माई पॉइंट विल नॉट बी क्लियर एल्स. जैसे हम सब उनका एक बहुत फेमस गाना है प्रभु तेरो नाम, या कभी खुद पे कभी हालात पे रोना आया, तो उसको वो इमिजिएटली चेंज करते हैं. मतलब एक एस्टैब्लिश कर देते हैं एक लाइन, लेकिन उसको इमिजिएटली अगले ही लाइन में वही लाइन वो गाएंगे थोड़ी वेरिएशंस के साथ, और ये हमेशा नज़र आता है. कभी खुद पे कभी हालात पे रोना आया, कभी खुद पे कभी हालात पे रोना आया. मतलब एक लाइन एस्टैब्लिश करके उसको चेंज किया. सेम इज विद प्रभु तेरो नाम एंड मेनी अदर सॉन्ग्स आर देयर. सो इम्प्रोवाइजेशन एलिमेंट एक ये आ गया, और काफ़ी सारे हैं इफ टाइम परमिट्स.
यस, विल कम बैक टू दैट. इनफैक्ट मैं पूछना चाह रही थी कि आपने क्योंकि क्लासिकल म्यूजिक की बात की, तो मुझे लगता है कि वन ऑफ द हॉलमार्क्स ऑफ क्लासिकल म्यूजिक इज द एलिमेंट ऑफ विस्तार एंड बढ़त, एंड द आइडिया ऑफ द कंपोजिशन एक्चुअली बीइंग अ सीड, अ वेरी स्मॉल सीड. सो इट डजंट हैव इट, इफ यू जस्ट सैंग द सॉन्ग इट वुड बी ओवर मे बी इन अ फ्यू सेकेंड्स और अ मिनट. But the idea of being able to elaborate, to actually bloom and blossom and really explore a rag through that particular seed composition is the hallmark, which we do not see in film song. In fact, the element of vistar is actually converted into a song. So I'm going to ask you, all of you, Kaushal ji, what is, in according to you, is there a structure of the film song? Is there any structure? Are there any elements that make you say that, okay, this is a film song? Of course, other than its association with a film. But what are the elements, as a student of music, what are the elements in that song form that make it particular to a Hindi film song?
Mr. Shahani touched upon it briefly in the previous session, that a film song is necessarily part of storytelling. So if it is telling a story, the character should sing, not the composer. So like in a play or in a film script, it's the language of the character should be his or her own, not that of the author. So there are many stories which every character starts philosophizing. You can't have that even in a song. So for example, I'll give you Amar Akbar Anthony. My name is Anthony Gonsalves, this song. Now you can't use the words like kabhi khud pe kabhi halat pe, because Anthony Gonsalves will not be able to pronounce khud. So he has to say my name is Anthony Gonsalves, karega darega marega, he has to do that. So that is the only thing. We are speaking in Ashok Ranade's convince, the name is his. He used to he had classified it broadly as Jana Sangeet. So in his classification, he had classified film songs in a genre called Jana Sangeet, so which includes light music as well. Now, I see, I'll give you an analogy of, you said about Vistar and Badhat in classical music, right? So it's like a classical musician, a vocalist or even a instrumentalist has a small brown packet in which in a mehfil he opens it and then he starts putting out things, or like a magician out of a rabbit's hat, out of a hat, he starts pulling out many things, and you are surprised at how many things are coming out of that hat. In light music, you are taking an empty hat and moving around in the world and getting things in that hat. So you are putting things in the hat. In classical music, you are opening things. In Indian classical music, you are opening things. So I faced a very peculiar problem when I was doing the music of Bal Gandharva. See, Bal Gandharva, the problem was that we couldn't use the old recordings because they were faultily recorded. Now you are seeing the film in 70mm screen, digital quality, and you can't have a hiss and crackles in a recording, so we couldn't use the, so we had to re-record. Now, because this movie is on a singer, and not just a singer, he is worshipped in Maharashtra, even in some parts of Karnataka. Now, it's, my main problem was casting the voice of Bal Gandharva, because you cannot replicate a miracle. Tomorrow, if you say, I want to make a film on Lata Mangeshkar, but the condition is that you won't use the voice of Lata Mangeshkar, what will you do? So I had to find a voice which was not a bad imitation of Bal Gandharva, because otherwise it will be an imitation, but it should be convincing that it's Bal Gandharva song. After a lot of deliberation and almost 40 auditions, we came to Anand Bhatte. Anand Bhatte, as you know, was a child prodigy. He sang at the age of 10. He sang Bal Gandharva's padas like he used to sing. Now, when I approached him, he had never sung for a film song. So he had no experience of singing on a track. So now what to do? Because he couldn't sing. Now he sang all Bal Gandharva songs in this manner, doing Badhat, improvising. So what we did was, like students, Aditya Oak was assisting me on that project, and we both sat in front of Anand Bhatte, and we gave a loop of tabla in his and tanpura in his ears, and we recorded 20 minutes of all the Natya Sangeet that he sang, and then we edited it to 5 minutes. And then we did the arrangement of the song on the vocals. So the entire process had to go reverse.
So are you saying then that the structure of the film song is to have a sthai interspersed with music interludes? Is there a standard or a structure that has emerged, or is it flexible?
Now you can see that it is flexible, because lot of many new genres, not Indian and not traditional, are coming in. So we are using very unconventional genres, we are using very unconventional methods even to project traditional music. For example, in Delhi 6, Rehman has used an old Bade Ghulam Ali Khan Sahab recording, interspersed with Sharia's voice. So this is a new form. Absolutely. It's not just Thai and Antara, because Thai comes, then Shreya Ghoshal sings the Thai again, then it comes back to Bade Gulam Ali Khan Saab Antara, and then the whole song is repeated by Shreya Ghoshal.
But that's an exception.
It's an exception, but there is scope.
So there is a flexibility. There is a flexibility.
Yes.
Tusharji, what do you feel?
I feel that whatever you asked, if you actually go and study the earlier composers, they were classically trained. I'm talking about R.C. Bural, Pankaj Malik. They have done Vistar in their 3-minute songs. The way the Asthai starts, Jeevan Bin Madhur Na Baje, if you know the song, it's like an alap. From where the
It's not an alap. It's like a bol alap. Yeah, okay. Whether it's an alap or a bol alap, but the element of vistar that we see in Lagdari music can't be there.
No, it's not that. They only use the element of that. It's not a classical piece.
Yes.
I am saying that, but they have used the elements of that. That it is. It starts like how you would have a bol alap before the tabla starts. Just an introduction. Kahin se shuru hokar, what he has done, what R.C. Bural Sahab has done is, he is extremely difficult to fathom in terms of a structure. You asked about question about structure, so I'm coming to that. I'm talking about 30s now. Because when the grammar was being written, which was followed for the next 70 years, now since digital music has come, things have changed. Composers are listening more and more to Western music, and the song structures are extremely pop music-like. So I'm not getting into that just now. I'm talking about answering your question. That was there a vistar scope? Bol vistar, bol banao, bandish ki jo bol banao hote hain. Rai Babu, R.C. Bural Sahab, was a very great tabla player. He used to accompany Baba Alauddin and Inayat Khan Sahab, and he was classically trained. He followed those structures but adapted them to new forms. He created a new form. Jeevan Bin is just one example. Koi samjhawe git sakhi kya hai, or he also used a very traditional thumri, Babul Mora Nehar Chuto Jai. Balam Aaye Baso More Man Mein is a piece in Desh, which Timir Baran Sahab, who was a disciple of Baba Alauddin and a great sarod player, he introduced sarod with that song in 35 in Devdas. Now, if you hear that song also, Saigal Sahab's song, there is a build-up which is almost on the structures of classical build-up. Vilambit hai, drut hai, bich mein jhala bachta hai, but it is not classical song. जो स्कोप होता है क्लासिकल म्यूजिक में विस्तार करने का, जो एक अंग लेके आप उसको बढ़त करते हो और उसमें पूरी ऑडियंस को लेकर चलते हो, दे ट्राई टू यूज दोज एलिमेंट्स बट क्रिएटेड फ्रेश स्ट्रक्चर्स. लेटर ऑन, बिकॉज ऑर्केस्ट्रा वॉज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड, यानी मोर देन 20-30 इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स, एंड देन पियानो केम, डबल बेस केम, सो ऑल द इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स हैड टू डू डिफरेंट रोल्स. रिदम भी दे रहा है, कभी ये दे रहा है, कभी काउंटर मेलोडी चल रही है. सो it could not be a khayal structure or a typical folk song structure. But they have, as he said, that they have used the elements, created a new form, and Kabhi Khud Pe Za Ghazal, Jaydev Ji was a master of ghazals, he was a master of thumris. I mean, not an exaggeration. So, Tu Chanda Mein Chandni, ek gana hai, kaise chalta hai wo gana, kaise wo maand mein, kya kya desh mein, kaise kya kya kiya hai. He was a classically trained musician by Baba Alauddin and Ali Akbar Khan Sahab. So he was into that. But still he created a new song, Lata Ji Ka Gana. Kya kya usme kehna hai. So, ye sab log jo the, they wanted to be in the aura of Indianness, if I can say that. They wanted to be in the aura of Indianness. And abhi example aapko deta hun, Madan Mohan Sahab ka gana. Shokh Nazar Ki Bijliyan, Dil Pe Mere Giraye Ja. वो कौन थी का गाना है. इट्स एक्चुअली अ कैबरे, लेकिन जो उसमें आशा जी के जो वेरिएशन मदन जी ने दिए हैं उसमें बिल्कुल गजल का रंग निकलता है. वो मदन जी का टेम्परमेंट था, उनको बहुत अच्छा लगता था वो, और वो बहुत अच्छे से किया है, ऐसे नहीं लगता कि ये कोई. अभी एस डी बर्मन साहब, हु वॉज सच अ ट्रेडिशनली फैबुलस कंपोजर, ही यूज सो मेनी फोक एलिमेंट्स. वी ऑल नो सुन मेरे बंधुरे एंड वहाँ कौन है तेरा, एंड वी डोंट नीड टू इलेबरेट ऑन दैट. बट बर्मन दा हैविंग डन ऑल दोज ग्रेट सॉन्ग्स एंड यूज भटियाली एंड बाउल एंड कीर्तनंग्स एंड थ्रू आउट हिज करियर एंड ब्रिलियंटली, इन फैक्ट ही यूज रविंद्र संगीत सो ब्यूटिफुली, तेरे मेरे मिलन किए रहना. बर्मन दा हैविंग डन ऑल दैट could come up with lovely seductive numbers, cabarets, Raat Akeli Hai, and all these kind of songs, which Pancham Da carried on further. He didn't want to be an S.D. Barman, but he was also melodious, very, very great composer. So, wo sare elements, jo aap structure ki baat kar rahe ho, structure dheere dheere badalta gaya. Lekin, jaise aapne poocha, mukhda, antra, beech mein music, this was an invention of Pankaj Malik. He brought in this. Rai Babu did not do this. R.C. Boral sahab ka music mein bahut opening mein music rehta tha. In fact, दादरा में म्यूजिक है तो कहरवा में गाना है, कहरवा में म्यूजिक है तो दादरा में गाना है, ये सब चलता था राय बाबू का, क्योंकि वो लगियां और सब दिमाग में उनके थी. ही वाज अ ग्रेट लवर ऑफ ठुमरी एंड दादरा. तो कानन देवी के ऐसे बहुत सारे गाने हैं. एक गाना है, आपको चांस मिले तो सुनाइए, मैं अभी लाया नहीं हूँ, कौन मन लुभाया मेरे मन में आया. उसका जो म्यूजिक है बिल्कुल विस्तार अंग से चलता है, विस्तार वो फ्रेज का विस्तार हो रहा है, और विस्तार भी अनिक्वल लय का विस्तार हो रहा है. ये नहीं कि चार मात्रे है फिर वापस दूसरे चार मात्रे, ऐसे नहीं, दो मात्रे, तीन मात्रे, चार मात्रे, लेकिन उसी अंग पे खत्म होता है, जैसे हम ख्याल की या ठुमरी की आप विस्तार करते हैं. तो यही बात है कि स्ट्रक्चर्स बदलते गए, और अभी तक टिल पंचमदा और टिल इवन आफ्टर दैट वो स्ट्रक्चर्स थे, जब तक डिजिटल नहीं आया था, यूट्यूब नहीं आया था, और गाने इधर उधर से भी जो भी है, आपके नाटक में बहुत अच्छा दिखाया है आपने, वो म्यूज़िक दिया है, म्यूजिकल स्टोरीज इन अ सॉन्ग, कि कैसे क्लासिकल म्यूजिशियन जिंदगी भर का रियाज करता है, बेचारा गाना बंदिश बनाता है, कहाँ से कोई उठा लेता है. तो अभी गुजरी तोड़ी बड़े गुलाम अली खान साहब की जो है, वो जिन्होंने ले लिया है उनको शायद उसके आरोबरों भी नहीं मालूम है. तो वो भी हो सकता है कि ख्याल भोर भई तोरी बाट तकत पिया जो खान साहब का है, खान साहब ने उसमें ज़िंदगी गुजारी है. बड़े गुलाम अली खान साहब भी कोई मैजिक से कम नहीं है, वो एक क्या है मुझे कहने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. तो जैसे शोभा गुट्टू जी की बात कर रहा हूँ, शोभा जी ने मुझे कहा था कि बर्मनदा ने उनको बुलाया, फिल्म थी फागुन. मैंने कहा वो गाना कैसे बना जो फागुन में आपका दादरा है तो सैया मोरे. तो बोले बर्मनदा ने मुझे बुलाया और कहा शोभा ये यहाँ पे ऐसी सिचुएशन है, मुझे बैकग्राउंड में एक दादरा देना है. तो शोभा जी ने कहा अच्छा मैं बनाती हूँ. तो उन्होंने वो अस्थाई अंतरा लिखा और बर्मनदा ने उधर दिया. बर्मनदा का जीनियस कहाँ है कि कहाँ पे क्या अच्छा लगेगा, ये उनका जीनियस है कि उनको वहाँ शोभा गुट्टू की आवाज़ बैकग्राउंड म्यूजिक में चाहिए थी. तो एक और बात मैं शोभा जी आपकी इजाज़त से कहना चाहूँगा कि वी आर ओनली टॉकिंग अबाउट सॉन्ग्स, फिल्म म्यूजिक इज नॉट जस्ट सॉन्ग्स, देयर इज बैकग्राउंड स्कोर.
यस बट आवर डिस्कशन इज ऑन
फॉर व्हिच यू वोंट कॉल मी. ओके वी लीव इट टू दैट.
Yeah, I wanted to say that, would you agree that sometimes when a traditional form of music is brought in into Hindi film song, let's say, for example, Qawwali. Now, we know that Qawwali has a certain ruhaniyat associated with it. But once it came into the films, it also turned into this aashiqana. Very often it even turned into a muqabla. And I think Anna ji has written very beautifully about this element of qawwali in films. So do you have other examples of a well-established form of traditional music which when adapted into films became in the popular understanding something quite different from it what it was originally?
Asking me?
Yes, all of you.
I think ghazals became very popular with films. Film ghazals are different from what Begum Akhtar ji sang and what she sang, Kabhi Khud Pe Kabhi Halat Pe. I mean, great composers like Pankaj Malik or Anil Vishwas or Madan Mohan, Jaydev ji, Naushad ji, all of them, they now Jawah Hai Mohabbat, it's a fast-paced dholak ka gana, Noor Jahan ji ka. It's a ghazal. It's a proper ghazal. पोएटिकली इच्छा गज़ल, चारों अंतरे उसके अलग हैं, उसमें मज़ा ये है कि वो कहाँ वापस पहली लाइन पे लिंक होता है. इट्स अ न्यू फॉर्म ऑफ गज़ल दैट नौशाद साहब डिसाइडेड टू क्रिएट. एस डी बर्मन साहब, तदबीर से बिगड़ी हुई तकदीर बना ले और जीवन के सफ़र में राही, किशोर कुमार का गाना, ये गज़ल है, ये साहिर साहब की लिखी हुई गज़ल है, लेकिन उसको क्या अलग फॉर्म दिया, अलग चीज़ उसको करके दिया, क्योंकि वो सिचुएशनल पे है. एज ही सेड, शी सेड दैट सिचुएशनल गाने हैं, हीरो कैसा दिखता है, एम्बियंस क्या है उसकी, ये सब. और किशोर दा गाने वाले थे तो अलग अलग स्टाइल की ट्यून चाहिए.
मृदुला जी, वुड यू लाइक टू कमेंट ऑन दैट?
आई विल नॉट रिपीट बिकॉज व्हाट ही टोल्ड इज वेरी सेल्फ एक्सप्रेसिव. लेकिन रूहानियत की जो बात आपने की वो बिल्कुल सही है, और मेरे ख्याल से जो सिचुएशन की डिमांड है तो मोर हिंदी फिल्म्स और हमारी जो स्टोरीज़ हैं वो डील करती हैं मैन एंड वुमेन रिलेशनशिप. तो हम नेचुरली स्टोरीज जो बनती हैं वो इन दोनों के बीच के संबंध के जो ताने बाने हैं, मेनी एंगल्स आर डिस्कस्ड, एंड जो कथा होती है उसमें ये सब चीज़ें ज़्यादा दिखाई देती हैं. और रूहानियत जो है वी आर मोर टू आशिकाना टाइप ऑफ द कंटेंट. कोई भी अगर विधा हो, क्लासिकल हो या कव्वाली हो, गज़ल हो, अल्टीमेटली हिंदी फिल्म सॉन्ग में आके रोमांटिक क्यों बन जाती हैं, ये हमेशा देखा गया है कि क्योंकि 90% ऑफ फिल्म्स आर लाइक दैट. दे आर सर्चिंग मेनी एंगल्स, मेनी बिटवीन द लाइन्स कंटेंट बिटवीन मैन एंड वुमन रिलेशनशिप. तो एक ये रीज़न हो सकता है.
एनी अदर एग्जाम्पल ऑफ अ फॉर्म दैट हैज सॉर्ट ऑफ सीन अ ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन?
I don't know, but folk music has seen a lot of transformation in as it is used. Like for example, Mand, Jaydev ji in Tu Chanda Mein Chandni completely transformed that traditional Mand into a film song. But speaking of Kavwali again, you know, a French musician friend of mine once asked me, why do you Indians turn everything into a love song? So I said, because even if we want to express philosophy, we do it through a love song. Like our treatises of mathematics are written in poetry. It's in the same manner we express, even if we want to express some very primary philosophy of life, we express it through love song. There are lot of examples like this. That is more to do with poetry than to do with the music. Yes, Kavwali is definitely changed, ghazals definitely changed. In a recent film I did a ghazal in blues. I think film music is one genre in a very not speaking of it derogatorily, in a very positive way, I think film music is the most opportunistic form of music. They will take good from anything and they will use it. So they find something and they will change the form, will change something and mix two things, three things. There is scope. There is pure freedom of expression in in film music.
Let's hope it is retained.
Shubhaji, isme kyunki ट्रेडिशनल उर्दू इसमें इश्क हबीबी और इश्क हकीकी ये एक्चुअली जायज़ फॉर्म्स हैं, ये बने हुए फॉर्म्स हैं कि लव फॉर महबूबा एंड लव फॉर खुदा. तो वो दोनों फॉर्म्स को यूज़ किया है. रोशन साहब ने बहुत अच्छी कवाली वैसी भी बनाई है जो आप कह रहे हैं ना कि इश्क भगवान के लिए इसको, तो वो रोशन साहब की कवालियाँ जग मशहूर हैं. और दोनों ही, और दूसरा मुकाबला जब होता है तो मज़ा आता है ना. फाइनली इट इज़ एंटरटेनमेंट.
नहीं नहीं, मज़ा तो
नहीं फॉर द पब्लिक
है ही. मैं कहने की कोशिश ये कर रही हूँ कि उसका जो session is for discussion on traditional music and how it has impacted Hindi film song. I think one of the things that we would all agree upon is that the Hindi film song as a genre is very hybrid. It brings together many, many influences, and in this session we have three very eminent panelists who will tell us what they think is the impact of many, many forms of traditional music in India, how that has impacted Hindi film song. So I'd like to welcome Tushar Bhatia ji. So Tushar ji is a very eminent composer. He has studied Hindustani classical music at depth, and of course is a very accomplished sitar player himself. But he also has a formidable study of many, many other forms of music, including Western classical music. He has provided the music for several films, for many projects, and has also created education modules for music education purposes. I'd now like to call Mr. Kaushal Inamdar, another very well-known composer. Kaushalji is an author, a poet, and a composer. His work in composing for films has been greatly acclaimed, and in fact, there's a huge list of awards that he has received, and many more I'm sure that will come. But one of the most, the one that caught my eye was for his work, the music that he composed for the film Bal Gandharv, for which he received the Dada Saheb Phalke Memorial Award. I'd also like to invite Mrudula Dadhe Joshi. She is an assistant professor in the music department in the University of Bombay. But her work, her research work, has been focused on Hindi film music, and she has been awarded a PhD thesis on her work in studying composers for Hindi films who have had an experimental streak. She's also written many, many papers, academic papers, on the work of several composers. So basically, all three of these eminent panelists share one thing in common, a deep and abiding interest in studying not just music, but film music in particular. The first question that I would like to put to all of you, and maybe Tusharji, you can start, is to briefly tell us that in this very hybrid world of the Hindi film song, do you think, is there a DNA, is there a gene of traditional music that can be traced in the evolution of the Hindi film song genre? And if so, please tell us what you think, briefly, because we have much to discuss. So what is the impact of traditional music and where do you find that?
As it goes, film music, everything goes. We are allowed to do everything. I'll go back to 1931 when talkie cinema started. Anil Bishwas ji, the great composer, who came in immediately, almost immediately after R.C. Boral ji and Pankaj Malik cast their spell in new theatres in the early 30s. And he says, I came away to Bombay because nobody was looking at me in Calcutta. He says, first I came and then S.D. Parman Sahab also came. And he says, when I came, which means around 35, 36, Dharam Ki Devi was his first film. He says, I had a blank canvas. I could paint whatever I wanted. And he says, I also worked with non-singers who were stars, and it was being lapped up. Now, earlier, in the 30s, 40s, since there was no tradition of film music, since it was a blank canvas, there was theatre music, there was classical music, thumris, ghazals, folk music, many forms. All forms of folk music, of course, existed for thousands of years. My hand is... So, I think in the beginning, it was highly influenced by theatre music, when singers sang loudly and there was just minimum instruments, as in tabla, and harmonium also, which was actually not an Indian instrument, has become so Indian now that people forget that it's not even an Indian instrument. And it's considered as the very, very basic form of harmonium. So all the genres, which was including ghazals, were used very heavily. The main language was Urdu in talkie cinema. And folk forms, we find them in the 30s, eventually with playback coming in and technology increasing, you had a tapestry of musicians which was called the orchestra. That itself was an innovation. And if I'm not mistaken, that was done by Pankaj Malik Sahab and R.C. Boral Sahab in new theatres. They put in about 13, 14 to 20 musicians together. And obviously, when the musicians were playing together, they were not playing only one thing. They were playing several parts. Now, this was a big breakaway from traditional music, as we know folk music and classical music to be, because we have a single form of
session. is for discussion on traditional music and how it has impacted Hindi film song. I think one of the things that we would all agree upon is that the Hindi film song as a genre is very hybrid. It brings together many, many influences, and in this session, we have three very eminent panelists who will tell us what they think is the impact of many, many forms of traditional music in India, how that has impacted Hindi film song. So I'd like to welcome Tushar Bhatia ji. Tushar ji is a very eminent composer. He has studied Hindustani classical music at depth, and of course is a very accomplished sitar player himself. But he also has a formidable study of many, many other forms of music, including Western classical music. He has provided the music for several films, for many projects, and has also created education modules for music education purposes. I'd now like to call Mr. Kaushal Inamdar, another very well-known composer. Kaushal ji is an author, a poet, and a composer. His work in composing for films has been greatly acclaimed, and in fact there's a huge list of awards that he has received, and many more I'm sure that will come. But one of the most, the one that caught my eye was for his work, the music that he composed for the film Bal Gandharv, for which he received the Dada Saheb Phalke Memorial Award. I'd also like to invite Mrudula Dadhe Joshi. She is an assistant professor in the music department in the University of Bombay. But her work, her research work, has been focused on Hindi film music, and she has been awarded a PhD thesis on her work in studying composers for Hindi films who have had an experimental streak. She's also written many, many papers, academic papers, on the work of several composers. So basically all three of these eminent panelists share one thing in common, a deep and abiding interest in studying not just music, but film music in particular. The first question that I would like to put to all of you, and maybe Tushar ji, you can start, is to briefly tell us that in this very hybrid world of the Hindi film song, do you think is there a DNA, is there a gene of traditional music that can be traced in the evolution of the Hindi film song genre? And if so, please tell us what you think, briefly, because we have much to discuss. So what is the impact of traditional music, and where do you find that?
As it goes, film music, everything goes. We are allowed to do everything. I'll go back to 1931 when talkie cinema started. Anil Bishwas ji, the great composer, who came in almost immediately after R.C. Boral ji and Pankaj Malik cast their spell in new theatres in the early 30s. And he says, I came away to Bombay because nobody was looking at me in Calcutta. He says, first I came and then S.D. Parman Sahab also came. And he says, when I came, which means around 35, 36, Dharam Ki Devi was his first film. He says, I had a blank canvas. I could paint whatever I wanted. And he says, I also worked with non-singers who were stars, and it was being lapped up. Now, earlier, in the 30s, 40s, since there was no tradition of film music, since it was a blank canvas, there was theatre music, there was classical music, thumris, ghazals, folk music, many forms. All forms of folk music, of course, existed for thousands of years. My hand is...
So, I think in the beginning, it was highly influenced by theatre music, when singers sang loudly and there was just minimum instruments. as in tabla. And harmonium also, which was actually not an Indian instrument, has become so Indian now that people forget that it's not even an Indian instrument. And it's considered as the very, very basic form of harmonium. So all the genres, which was including ghazals, were used very heavily. The main language was Urdu in talkie cinema. And folk forms, we find them in the 30s, eventually with playback coming in and technology increasing, you had a tapestry of musicians which was called the orchestra. That itself was an innovation. And if I'm not mistaken, that was done by Pankaj Malik Sahab and R.C. Boral Sahab in New Theatres. They put in about 13, 14 to 20 musicians together. And obviously, when the musicians were playing together, they were not playing only one thing. They were playing several parts. Now, this was a big breakaway from traditional music, as we know folk music and classical music to be, because we have a single form of music, a single line of music, monophonic form. So, even if the traditional forms like Dhire Baho Nadia, Dhire Dhire Baho Utar Nahi Paaye, Achyut Kanya Ka Gaana, or Chudi Lelo Main Laaya Anmol Re, they were still in a very different genre that was being created by the masters. And a new grammar was being written for the films in the 30s. Eventually, in 40s, 50s, 60s, and till now, there has been actually a tradition of... I was extremely thrilled with that. So, ab main baitha. Yahan pe jo log classical music sunte hain, unko shayad hansi aa jaye. Mujhe jo situation actual hua wo. To mujhe kuch sooj nahi raha tha. Meri neend haram, mera khana peena haram. Mujhse ho nahi raha hai. Izzat ka sawal hai ki mujhe karna hai aur nahi ho raha hai. To maine bola, bol deta hu, mujhse nahi ho raha hai. Jaane do, mujhe nahi karni picture. To mujhe thoda relax hona tha. तो प्रभा अत्रे जी का रिकॉर्ड मैंने लगाया, तोपे वारू तन मन धन, बहुत फेमस चीज़, मैं बहुत टीनेज में सुनता था, एक ताल की चीज़ मुझे बहुत पसंद है. प्रभा जी का गाना मुझे, मेरी कहने की चीज़ नहीं है. तो कलावती के सुर, और मेरा बेसिक टेम्परामेंट तो रागों का ही है, मुझे बहुत पसंद है. तो वो बैठ के मैं सुन रहा था, हो गया, सुन लिया, पता नहीं कब नींद आई. व्हेन आई वोक अप, आई हैड दिस with the words, I had this thought in my mind, this melody, I don't know where it came from. Dil karta hai tere paas aaun, tere paas aake tera ho jaun, pa ga pa dha ni da, ga pa sa ni da, pa ga pa ga sa ga pa dha ni da, pa. Ye Kalavati mein gaana hai. Usko maine ek shuddh nishaan jod diya, usko khamaaj ka touch de diya. Okay. रसते रसते गलियों गलियों कहाँ था फिरूं मैं दीवाना अब तो गले से लगाना whatever. तो वो words भी मेरे थे, मजरू साहब ने उसको कबूल किए, ये मेरा सौभाग्य.
इसने arrangement भी कर दिया आपके लिए, देखिए पीछे से कुछ phone पे बज रहा है कुछ.
तो ये जैसे आपने पूछा ना कि कैसे हम जो चीज हमें इतनी पसंद, उसका मतलब ये नहीं कि वहाँ पे एक ताल में कलावती की चीज बजेगी.
Whose phone is this?
Oh, achha. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry for this.
Anyway, I think there must be lots of questions that the audience would like to ask. So if you could.
Hello. सबसे माफ़ी मांग के क्वेश्चन पूछ रहा हूँ क्योंकि बहुत दिग्गज लोग बैठे हैं. कौशल जी नमस्ते, मराठी आहे मी आणि बालगंधर्वबद्दल खूप खूप शुभेच्छा. तुषार जी थैंक यू, एवढा चांगल्या काळामध्ये तुम्ही आपने जो अच्छा गाना दिया था येलो येलो मेरा फेवरेट है. और आपने जो एक गाने में ट्रांजिशन बताया था, मैं कुछ क्वेश्चन नहीं पूछ रहा हूँ, मेरी एक बात रखना चाहता हूँ आपकी इजाज़त से. शोभा जी, तो जो आपने गाना गाया था जिसमें वो ट्रांजिशन था, अलग थोड़ा इम्प्रोवाइजेशन था, तो मैंने जैसे बताया कि मैं कानसेन भी नहीं हूँ, तानसेन तो बहुत दूर की बात है. तो हमको ना जैसे कि एक ले मैन लाइक हिंदी म्यूज़िक में जो हम लोग, क्योंकि पोएट्री या पोएट्री बताना या सुनना एक
थोड़ा सा लाउड कर देंगे प्लीज़, समझ में नहीं आ रहा क्या कह रहे हैं.
हाँ, जो मैं मतलब बताने जा रहा हूँ
भाई साहब उधर. हाँ, लाउड कर दीजिए.
कैन यू हेयर मी? हेलो हेलो,
चेक थोड़ा सा,
चेक राइट सर?
हाँ जी
ओके. हाँ, तो जैसे कि एक लेमैन के हिसाब से मैं बोल रहा हूँ कि जैसे आपने इम्प्रोवाइजेशन बताया तो हमको वो इम्प्रोवाइजेशन वही मालूम पड़ा, क्योंकि आपका जो क्लासिकल सिंगिंग है, रॉकस्टार का एक मुझे सीन याद आता है, शम्मी कपूर जी, रणबीर कपूर जी बैठे हैं, वो बोलता है मैं जानता हूँ आपको बहुत दिग्गज हो आप, लेकिन एक ही चीज़ आप बार बार गा रहे हो, थोड़ा आगे भी निकल जाइए। तो उस चीज़ का मैं थोड़ा सा ये हूँ। तो इसमें जैसे आपने इम्प्रोवाइजेशन बताया, मैंने वो पाया जो एक गाना है सत्य पे सत्ता में, इसमें वो चेंज है, सत्य पे सत्ता में एक गाना था
सत्य पे सत्ता, हाँ
प्यार हमें, पहले वो सैड में था प्यार हमें इस, फिर बाद में वो इम्प्रोवाइज होता था जो बहुत कॉन्ट्रास्ट है प्यार हमें इस, ये चीज़ें हमें समझ में आती है। सेकंडली मैं ये बताना चाह रहा हूँ कि ये जो पूरा क्लासिकल का है मतलब माहौल, तो मैंने एक सॉन्ग सुना था जैसे आपने बताया था कि क्लासिकल आप उसमें डालते हो, तो हमको ये समझ में आता है कि जो एक गाना था हेरा फेरी का भी,
क्या
हेरा फेरी जो गाना था अक्षय कुमार की, उसमें एक गाना था जिसमें मुझे लगा कहीं पर क्लासिकल टच है, मुझे पता नहीं चलता है, लेकिन वो जो गाना है,
आपको प्रश्न नहीं है?
नहीं प्रश्न नहीं, मैं बात इसके लिए रखना चाहता हूँ कि एक नॉर्मल जो इंसान आदमी पिक्चर देखता है,
हाँ, वो क्लासिकल, तो एक नहीं
क्लासिकल,
समझ पाता
क्लासिकल से उसमें एक एक ही मैं बात बता के मैं खत्म करना चाहता हूँ बात, शायद मैं कन्फ्यूज आई एम नॉट एबल टू यू नो, तो उसमें एक एक ही गाना है कि लाइक जब भी कोई हसीना देखूं मेरे दिल के तार बजे बार बार, तो ये जो गाने हैं ना ये हमको बहुत पसंद है, इसमें भी मुझे लगता है कहीं पर क्लासिकल, और बोला जाता है कि हर गाने में राग होता है, तो वो चीज जरा मुझे एलोबरेट हो जाती है तो बहुत अच्छा रहेगा सर।
कल्पेश
सवाल ये है कि ट्रेडिशन के फॉर्म हम बोल रहे हैं, एक मुझे पूछना है कि जो लोरी या अंगाई बोलते हैं उसमें कुछ ज्यादा फर्क हुआ है क्या? मुझे सुनने में नहीं आ रहा।
मुझे लगता है बहुत अच्छी अच्छी लोरियाँ हिंदी फिल्म में बनी है। मैं जवाब दूँ ना? सॉरी विथ योर परमिशन, राइट फ्रॉम सोजा राजकुमारी टू एस डी बर्मन साहब, नन्नी कली सोने चली, सलील चौधरी आजादी या निंदिया, तो बेसिकली माँ का भावना है जो उसको सुला रही है, एंड आर कंपोजर्स आर सो ग्रेट, उन्होंने क्या क्या नहीं किया है। तो ट्रेडिशनल लोरी की जो एक फॉर्म है वो कोई एक, वो सिर्फ एक फॉर्म है, वो सिर्फ शब्दों के साथ वो जो सुर का जो मीठापन होता है माँ की तरफ से जो होता है उसका एक फॉर्म है, उसको कंपोजर्स ने बहुत अच्छी तरह किया है। लोरी में तो शोरगुल तो नहीं हो सकता और कोई ऑर्केस्ट्रा भी नहीं हो सकता, बहुत ही धीमा म्यूजिक, आप देखिए जो भी लोरियां हैं तो सॉफ्ट म्यूजिक से ही होती हैं और बहुत अच्छी अच्छी लोरियां बनी हैं।
I'd like to connect to the previous panel and ask the two composers, what is your experience of writing songs that are to be lip-synced and songs which are to go in the background of films? If you could say you a bit about that.
Is it to me or is it?
Both of you, composers.
Okay. So the songs which are lip-synced is like Jaydeep ji also mentioned in his this, that it's the character who is singing. The songs which are in the background, most of the times they are the, it's a directorial comment on the film. So we treat it as at that, you know, like if it is a character singing, then you have to see whether the voice matches, whether the language in the song matches. And if it is a comment, then it is mostly it's a whim of the director or his thought. Not always a whim, but sometimes a thought that this I want. For example, I did a film called Ajanta, where actually it was based on a long poetry by N.D. Mahanur. There is a book called Ajanta. It's a like a khandakavya, a big poetry, long poetry. The whole book is in form of poetry. The story is in poetic form. Now there were many songs. There were 10 songs in the movie, and almost 9 songs out of 10 had a scope of lip sync. But the director, almost after recording the songs, he took a decision that he won't lip sync. So the calculation of the music director went for a toss. that I'll use this voice for this singer and that voice for this voice for that character and this voice for this character. It went out for a toss because it was decided at the last time, at the final moment, you know. So sometimes there is a difference in our approach, definitely. If the song is to be lip-synced, then the approach changes. If the song is to be put in the background, there is a different. Lot of times we treat it as a directorial comment. That the director wants to say something which might be awkward in maybe a dialogue form. For example, philosophizing sounds very awkward in speech. If it comes in a song, you accept it very easily. So
one of the best examples of this is Waqt Ne Kiya Kya Hansi Sitam. It comes as a background song. Another one, Mughal-e-Azam Ka Khuda Nigahban Ho Tumhara. When Anarkali is going away and she is going to the gallows, she cannot sing a song at that time. And Kya Asif Sahab and Naushad Sahab must have decided. Now the very, very great example is Sun Mere Bandhure.
Yeah.
And Chhaya Ji sitting here, finest song of Jaydev Ji, Aapki Yaad Aati Rahi Raat Bhar. It's a ghazal.
Many times it's more effective than...
It's more effective. Yeah. Actually, as if I can say this, it's a part of background score. A background song is a part of the background score, and as he very well said, when we do background scores, we have to say in music what the director is not saying in words. We have to get close to the director. It's a vision that merges. So these are some of the finest songs of films have been
sometimes
songs.
It's sung for the character, kyunki jo aapne abhi example diya ki suno mere bandhure ya SD Barman sahab ne gaaye hue kahi gaane aise hain ki jo फीमेल कैरेक्टर का एक्सप्रेशन
और बहुत सुंदर लगते हैं वो,
और कहीं पर जैरिंग नहीं हो रहा, उल्टा उसका इफेक्ट बढ़ रहा है
और बहुत ज्यादा अच्छे लगते हैं वो। मेरी दुनिया है माँ तेरे आंचल में, क्या बनाया है वो,
बंदिनी आराधना सुजाता,
बंदिनी
सुजाता, मेनी टाइम्स।
जस्ट वन थॉट दैट आई जस्ट हैड एट दिस मोमेंट, लिप सिंक क्रिस्टलाइजेस अ सिचुएशन इन अ song which is not lip synced, it's in the background, it goes towards abstraction. So that is a basic difference. If you want to crystallize, you have it lip synced. If you want to go into abstraction, you put it in the background.
So a question to all the eminent panelists out here, which in your opinion has been the most innovative adaptation of a classical song in a Hindi movie, with a small explanation maybe?
Impossible to.
Very difficult.
Very difficult. All the greats have done their own bit.
Something of your choice. Maybe one each. That'll help.
So many.
मैं एक ही example ऐसे देना चाहूँगी because it's very difficult to answer this question. लेकिन एक example ऐसा देना चाहूँगी कि राग को समझना और उसको गाने में ढालना एक अलग बात है क्योंकि music composer जो है वो राग को समझ के लेकिन लिरिक्स क्या हैं उस पर उसको बहुत ध्यान देना पड़ता है और एक एग्जांपल वसंत देसाई साहब का एक जाते जाते देना चाहूँगी कि हम सब जानते हैं तेरे सुर और मेरे गीत गाना है लेकिन हम कहते हैं ब्रॉडली कि ये बिहाग राग है या बिहाग पर आधारित है लेकिन सुनिए कि दो अंतरों में पहले अंतरे में जो वर्ड्स हैं वो अलग हैं और दूसरे अंतरे में एक ऐसा वर्ड आता है कि मुझको अगर भूल जाओगे तुम मुझसे अगर दूर जाओगे तुम मेरी मोहब्बत में तासीर है तो खींच के मेरे पास आओगे तुम और पहला अंतरा जो है उसमें धड़कन में तू है समाया हुआ ख्यालों में तू ही छाया हुआ दुनिया के मेले में लाखों मिले मगर तू ही तू दिल पे छाया हुआ मतलब यहाँ पे एक ट्रांजिशन देखते हैं कि एक सिंपल रोमांस है और उसके बाद का अंतरा ज़रा ज़्यादा सीरियस है डेप्थ है लव की जो दिखाई दी तो अगर एक सामान्य कंपोजर है तो अगर उसको एक क्रिएटिविटी में आ गया है ट्यून दिमाग में दोनों अंतरे को समान रूप से ही कंपोज करेगा और वैसे हैं भी वो सिमिलर अंतरा ट्यून में ज़्यादा फर्क नहीं है लेकिन कंपोजर्स क्रिएटिविटी कहाँ पे मुझे दिखाई देती है कि एक आलाप आता है और वो सिर्फ इस लाइन के बाद ही आता है कि मुझको अगर भूल जाओगे तुम मुझसे अगर दूर जाओगे तुम मेरी मोहब्बत में तासीर है मेरी मोहब्बत में तासीर हासिर है तू खींच के मेरे पास आओगे तुम देखो हमारी होगी जी और ये खींच के की जो मीट थी वो भी वो शब्द को ज्यादा उभरती है कि खींच के मेरे पास आओगे तुम और दोनों मिलकर बनेगी प्रीत द फ्रेज इज ऑन दोनों दोनों अगर ये नहीं आता तो उसकी ब्यूटी नहीं